गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, सो इन दिस वीडियो वी विल सी द डिजाइन प्रोसेस फॉर एम्बेडेड सिस्टम। द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट इन्वॉल्व इन द डिजाइन प्रोसेस ऑफ एम्बेडेड सिस्टम एंड ऑल्सो द मेजर गोल of the design to be considered is manufacturing cost, performance and power consumption. So at each step in the design process, we must consider the following details. That is, we must analyze the design at each step to determine how we can make the specifications. We must then refine the design to add detail. We must verify the design to ensure that it still meets all system goal such as cost, speed and so on. See the diagram. The first one is a requirement. Generally, requirement proceed in two phases. The first one is gather an informal description from the customer known as requirement. And second point, refine the requirement in an specification that contains enough information to begin designing the system architecture. So here, types of requirements, the first one is a functional requirement and second one is a non-functional requirement. See the functional requirement. So functional requirement means it dedicates the hardware component such as a input or output components, computing and communication components. These provide the basis for the design of hardware modules. Okay, that is application specific hardware to process input and output signals. Then external interfaces such as a serial interface, parallel interface, the network interface, radio interface, etc. Then user input device, that is a keyboard interface, then user output device, that is a LCD or LED display, etc. So these are all functional requirements. Then non-functional requirements includes performance. So performance means the speed of the system is often a major consideration both for the usability of the system and its ultimate cost. Then performance may be a combination of soft performance matrices such as approximate time to perform a user level functions and hard deadlines by which a particular operation must be completed. And second one, cost. The target cost or purchase price for the system is almost always a consideration. Cost typically has two major components. The first one, manufacturing cost, includes the cost of components and assembly, that is a non-recurring engineering cost, include the personal and other cost of designing the system. And third one is the physical size and weight. The physical aspect of the final system can vary greatly depending upon the application. An industrial control system for an assembly line may be designed to fit into a standard size rack with no strict limitation on weight. Then a handheld device typically has tight requirements on both size and weight that can ripple through the entire system design. These are the requirements needed for each one, that is a name, then purpose, then input, then what is output, then what about the function, then how it performs, cost, that is a manufacturing cost, then power supply, then a physical size and weight. Okay, so these informations are collected during requirement operation. Okay. Then power consumption. So power consumption means power is important in battery power system. Power can be specified in the requirement stage in terms of battery lifetime. Okay. So So this is first step. Then second step, that is a specification. The specification is more precise. It serves as the context between the customer and architect. Such as a specification must be carefully written so that it accurately reflects the customer requirement, and so in a way that can be clearly followed during a design procedure. The specification should be understandable enough so that someone can verify that it meets the system requirement and overall expectation of the customer. It should also be enough understandable that designer know what they need to build. That is, a designer can run into several different types of problems caused by unclear specification. Suppose if the behavior of the some features in a particular situation is unclear from the specification, the designer may implement the wrong function. So if global characteristics of the specification are wrong or incomplete, the overall system architecture derived from the specification may be inadequate to meet the needs of implementation. Okay, then third one, that is a third step, that is architecture design. The architecture is a plan for the overall structure of the system that will be used later to design the components that make up the architecture. The creation of the architecture is a first phase of what many designers think of as design. Then architectural description must be designed to satisfy both the functional and the non-functional requirements. Not only must all the required functions be present, but one must meet cost, speed, power, and other non-functional constraints. Then starting out with the system architecture and refining that to hardware and software architecture is one good way to ensure that the designer meet all specifications. The designer can concentrate on the functional elements in the system block diagram and then consider the non-functional constraints when creating the hardware and software architecture. So this is about this is the third step. Then fourth one, designing hardware and software components. The architectural description tells what components are needed. Okay, the components are design effort build those components in conformation to the architecture and specification. The components include both the software and hardware modules, example FPGA like that. Some of the components will be ready-made. For example, CPU will be a standard component in almost all cases, as will memory chips and many other components. Then last point is system integration. Only after the components are built do the designer have the satisfaction of putting them together and seeing a working system. So this phase usually consists of a lot more than just plugging everything together and standing back. Bugs are typically found during system integration, and good planning can help the designer to find the bugs quickly. By building up the system in a phase and running properly, chosen the test, the designer can often find bugs more easily. So if the designer debug only a few models at a time, the designer are more likely to uncover the simple bug and able to easily recognize them. Only by fixing the simple early will the designer are able to uncover more complex or obscure bugs that can be identified only by giving the system a hard workout. Okay, then the designer need to ensure during the architectural and components design phase, the designer make it easy as possible to assemble the system in phase and the test functions relatively independently. Then system integration is difficult because it usually uncover problems It is often hard to observe the system in sufficient detail to determine exactly what is wrong. So this is called design process for embedded system. So we can design either a top-down design or bottom-up design. Top-down design means the first step, the requirement, second one specification, third one architectural design, fourth one hardware and software components, and last one is a system integration. In bottom-up design means the first step is system integration, then hardware and software components, then architectural design, then specification, then requirements. So this is the difference between top-down design and bottom-up design. Then selection of processor. A hardware designer must take into account following process, specific features, so a hardware designer, that is a processor which can operate at a higher clock speed, processor more instruction per second, then a processor gives a high computing performance when there exists, that is a pipeline or superscalar architecture. Then prefetch cache unit catches and register files and MMU and RISC architecture. Then a processor with a register windows provide a fast context switching in a multitasking system. Then a power efficient embedded system requires a processor that has a programmable auto shutdown features for its unit and probably for disabling use of catches when the processing need for a function or instruction set is not constrained by limit on execution deadline. Then processor uses a stop, sleep and wait instruction and a special catch design. Then a processor that has a burst mode access external memories of fast, read fast and write fast. Then a processor with an automatic operation unit provides a hardware solution to share data problem. When designing embedded software, yields a special programming skill and effort are to be made when program uses a shared variable and data buffers among multiple tasks. Then when coding in an assembly language or a designing compiler or locator, data may store in big endian mode in a system and a lower bytes store at a higher address. For example, in motor law process, data may also store in a little endian mode in a system. Lower order bytes store at lower address and vice versa. For example, Intel processor, a processor may also be configured at the initial program stage, big endian or little endian storage of words, the ARM processor. Okay, then the processor selection process can be understood by considering the case shown in the table. So here, processor, what are the processor requirement for automatic chocolate vending machine and data acquisition system, real-time robotic control application. The first one is a required processor, that is microcontroller, and second one processor instruction cycle, that is in microseconds. Okay, so here required processor is microcontroller. Here 0.5 to 1 microsecond needed for that. Then processor performance, that is a low suffixes. Then internal bus width in bits, that is 8 bit. Then CISC or RISC architecture, any processor, that is a RISC based architecture or CISC based architecture. Then program counter, stack pointer, that is the size of program counter and stack pointer is a 16 bit. Then stack at external or internal memory, that is external memory is used. Then on chip atomic operation unit, no needed for that. Then pipeline and superscalar and pipeline architecture, no needed for that. Then off chip RAM in view of excessive RAM, no needed. On chip is enough for that. Then on-chip register window and files due to fast counter switches, switching needs no needed. Then interrupt handler, internal in microcontroller or external to processor, that is internal microcontroller is needed for that. So this is the example. Then how to select the memory devices? Selection of memory devices. Actually, the memory requirement is known only after coding as per the design function and specification. ROM memory, RAM memory, allocation for various segments, data sets and structures will be available from the software design. However, a prior estimate of the memory type and size requirement can be made. Okay, see the table. Memory requirement for the two different cases. Case 1 is nothing but automatic chocolate vending machine. Case 2, that is a data acquisition system. Here processor type, that is microcontroller, both are microcontroller. Then ROM memory or EEPROM memory. In case of a chocolate vending machine, 4 to 32 kilobyte memory is used. Whereas here data acquisition, that is 8 kilobyte of memory. Then internal EEPROM, here 256 to 512 bits. Here also the same memory. Then internal RAM, 256 to 512, here also the same. Then ROM or EEPROM device, no needed, both the cases. Then EEPROM or flash device, for automatic chocolate vending machine, no needed. Data acquisition system needs a 64 to 128 kilobyte of memory. Then RAM device, no needed. So, whereas data acquisition system needs 64 to 512 kilobytes. Then parameterized distributed RAM, no needed for automatic chocolate vending machine. Here also no needed. Then parameterized block RAM type, no needed both the cases. The memory are available as 1 kilobyte, 4 kilobyte, 16, 32, 64, 128, 256, 512, 1 MB. Suppose 100 kilobyte of memory is needed, then a device of 128 kilobyte is selected. So, in this way, the memory is selected. Thank you.